respected panel and audience. Before I make my submission to the half house, I have a question to all the audience. How many of you have read the Constitution of India? Kindly raise your hands. Only 10% have raised their hands. This was also a scenario about 15 years ago in a village in Rajasthan, Tilonia, where there was a gathering of 2,000 people. You must have heard about Aruna Roy, a social activist. None of the gathering of 2,000 raised their hand that they have heard about the Constitution of India. Well, they are villagers. One can excuse. She addressed a gathering of 400 chief executive officers of the private companies. And same question, how many of you have heard about the Constitution of India, not read? 4 people raised their hands out of 400. It is this country where we are talking of reforms on one sector. The biggest mistake, on the basis of my personal experience, I am saying you, biggest mistake which the Indian polity did in 1950, and we are suffering till today. Lowest priority to 3 sectors concerning the human life. One is health. It has got the bottom priority. Second is education, not literacy, please. Education, it has the second lowest priority. The third is law and order. Therefore, if Prakash Singh ji is to initiate the reforms in police and of course side by side reforms in the judiciary, then the first thing which is required to be done is to impress upon all concerned that the Constitution must be taught in class 9 or 10th of the education. Why the people should not know? I am sure some of you must have read it, but I would like to read 4 lines of the Constitution. Those beginning of the every citizen of this country is the ruler. That every student must know, that every citizen must know. We the people, solemnly resolve, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign democratic republic, socialist and secular were added in 1977. But this is not enough. There is a more important thing in the Constitution which the people do not understand, do not read it. I am sorry to say, 99.9999% people do not know what is the Constitution of India. The entire soul of the Constitution is in the preamble of the Constitution, and that is, second line is, and to secure to all its citizens. What was the vow we had taken on 26th of January 1950? Not only to declare ourselves to be a sovereign democratic republic, but to secure to all its citizens. First was justice. And justice accompanied by social, economic and political. Equality of status and of opportunity. I am throwing this point for your consumption on days to come. And one more important, all freedoms were there. freedom of trade, etc., etc., etc. Fraternity assuring dignity of the individual. When I was a child, my father was an advocate from 1942. Lot of clients would come. He was practicing on criminal cases also. Sometimes as a student of class 8, I used to go to the court and had great respect for the men in uniform. Great respect at that time. In fact, the great respect for civil servants also. Became a lawyer. Men in uniform became my clients. There was a slight dilution in the respect. Became a judge, came across the cases, still further dilution in the status of the men in uniform. Why? That agitated me for years together. I will not take much time, but because the all of you must have become loaded enough with the speeches of my predecessor speakers, but would like to share why it happens. As a judge, you come across several types of cases. And one was startling case in Haryana. Most of the speaker talked about shortage of manpower in police, that's a fact. Shortage of manpower in the judiciary, that's a fact. And both the systems are condemned by the people, by the politicians, by the media. Nobody bothers about shortage. 1,504 policemen were to be recruited in Haryana in all the districts. There was a challenge to the selection on the various grounds, including bribery. And you will be surprised to learn when the court directed the superintendents of police, who were the recruiting authority in the district, to file affidavits of their own to the allegation that each candidate had paid 75,000 rupees to the MLA concerned. Seven of the police officers had the guts to file an affidavit, this is correct. This is the foundation of the Indian police force. In our country, unfortunately, at every level, whether it is education, whether it is health, whether it is police, whether it is judiciary, the pyramid is upside down. Nobody bothers about the man at the grassroots, the policeman. I have been associated with the police in different ways. My brother-in-law also happened to be DGP and Special Secretary Home. I have personally seen, I have otherwise also seen, the constable polishing, cleaning the shoe of the Superna police in the open. I have recently seen a policeman carrying a umbrella over the head of a lady police officer. Side by side, I had the photographs of the American President Barack Obama carrying his own umbrella. Canadian Prime Minister walking on the street with his wife and two children. Netherlands Prime Minister going on bicycle to his office. This colonial mindset is the main cause why we have not been able to bring reforms in the police in last 75 years. And apart from reading the Constitution of India as class 8, I would request the entire audience, please read the speech of Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the greatest human who was born in this country on 15th of August 1947. Most of the people do not read him. because he is ancient. But what he said, just I will read two paragraphs from his speech, what Dr. Rajan Prasad had to say. What a man, I salute him always. After talking of independence, he says, आज से हम कानूनी तरीके से अपने भाग्य के विधाता बने हैं और इस देश की शांत सुखी और संपूर्ण बनाने का सारा भार हमारे ऊपर आ गया है. He is addressing the citizens, not the politicians. जो स्वराज हमने हासिल किया है वो खोखला रह जाएगा अगर हम अपने देश में रहने वाले सभी वर्ग जाति और धर्म वाले लोगों में यह विश्वास पैदा नहीं किया कि वह यहाँ सुरक्षित है और उनकी उन्नति और तरक्की के रास्ते में कोई भी बाधा नहीं डाल सकता. उनके धर्म और धर्माचार की पूरी आज़ादी है. उनकी भाषा और संस्कृति जमान और कल्चर पर कोई आँच नहीं पहुँचा सकता. आदिम जातियों और उससे पिछड़े हुए लोगों की उन्नति के लिए उस समय तक विशेष आयोजन और प्रयत्न होता रहेगा जब तक खास मदद होती रहेगी जब तक वह सबों की बराबरी पर न आ जाएं. आर्टिकल 14 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, इक्वालिटी ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड ऑफ स्टेटस, अबाउट लैंग्वेज एटसेट्रा, पार्ट 3 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, फ्रीडम्स. अछूतपन सपने की संकट की तरह हम भूल गए. मजदूर और किसान हर प्रकार से श्रमजीवी मेहनत करने वाले किसी प्रकार को शोषित नहीं होने पाएंगे. सभी लोगों को अपने विचारों को प्रकट और प्रसारित करने का, अपने अपने ख्यालों का इशायत करने का मौका होगा, अधिकार होगा. इस देश में खाने के लिए पूरा अन्न होने लगेगा और फिर दूध की नदियां बहने लगेगी. जब हमारे जवान लोग खेतों और कारखानों में हंसते हंसते काम किया करेंगे, जब हर झोपड़े और पल्ली में घरेलू धंधों के साथ हमारी युवतियाँ मीठे सुर अलापती रहेंगी, जब इस देश के सुखी घरों में और हंसते हुए चेहरों पर सूरज और चंद्रमा अपनी किरणें बिखोरेंगे. बट देयर इज वन थिंग मोर विच इज ऑफ मोस्ट वाइटल इंपॉर्टेंस इफ वी हैव टू ब्रिंग रिफॉर्म्स इन अवर कंट्री एट ऑल. जनता और जनता के प्रतिनिधियों के अलावा एक और वर्ग है, प्लीज पे अटेंशन टू दिस, एक और वर्ग है जिसकी जिम्मेदारी भी कम नहीं है. वह है हमारे देश की सेवा, सेना और सरकारी मुलाजिमों का. जो लोग आज तक हम पर और जनसाधारण पर हुकूमत करते रहे हैं एज एजेंट्स ऑफ ब्रिटिशर्स, उनको अब से सेवक और खादिम का जामा पहनना होगा. हमारी फौज ने अपनी बहादुरी और पूरे कौशल का सबूत दुनिया के अनेक देशों में दिया है. वह अब तक दूसरे प्रकार से संचालित हो रही थी, आज वह राष्ट्रीय सेना कौमी फौज बन गई है जिसके ऊपर देश को सुरक्षित महफूज रखने का भार होगा और जो जनता को दबाने के लिए नहीं, उठाने के लिए, उन्नत करने के लिए रखी जाएगी. अब हमारे देश में रहने वाले फौज के किसी भी विभाग में, चाहे वह जमीन, पानी, आसमान में काम करता हो, कोई भी ऐसी जगह नहीं होनी न मिल सके. इतना ही नहीं, उनको जल्द से जल्द ऊंचे से ऊंचे अहदे तक पहुंचकर काम संभालना है. उसी तरह, दिस इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट, उसी तरह जो सरकारी मुलाजिम हैं उनको अब अपने को देश का शासक न मानकर देश का सेवक मानना होगा. सर्वेंट्स ऑफ द कंट्री, नॉट द रूलर्स. सॉरी टू से, इन 75 ईयर्स द ब्रिटिश colonial mindset has not gone either from the politicians or from the bureaucrats or the higher police officers or the members of the judiciary. There is nothing, no place for the people. People are only asked to vote once in 5 years and then forgotten. We consider ourselves to be the masters of the people, and that is why we had the symbol like red light and red light substituted by the court and the prime minister with flags and big plates. Now the need for the police reforms which of course, one sentence which I came to my mind, बचपन में सुना करते थे कि अकेला चना भाड़ नहीं फोड़ सकता है, लेकिन यहाँ तो अकेला चना प्रकाश सिंह के नाम में मौजूद है जो भाड़ फोड़ने के लिए तैयार हैं। आई गिव फुल क्रेडिट टू मिस्टर प्रकाश सिंह एंड हिज टीम दैट दे हैव डन देयर ड्यूटी, नॉट दे हैव डन ग्रेट थिंग बट दे हैव डन ड्यूटी अंडर पार्ट 4A ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। दे मे सक्सीड, they may succeed after their death, but he will always be remembered that the person who took the cudgels to ensure that at least in one segment of the governance there were reforms, the police became people friendly. I was very thrilled to hear the two of the presentations made by the police officers. Kudos to them, they have done one in digitalization, other involving the female. And the police reforms, if they are to be brought, the only possibility, and police reforms must side by side go with the reforms in the judiciary, and then only the justice, social, economic and political, which is the goal set out in the preamble of the Constitution, 26th of January 1950, would become a reality. Now the mindset, how colonial mindset work, another example which came across my tenure in Punjab, Haryana. One gentleman belonging to a political outfit had jet security. Other gentleman recently in the jail had jet security. Wonderful it is. Gentleman I have to call, although he is not gentleman at all. The deeds which are being exposed will never call him gentleman. But that gentleman was given jet security because he was a member of the political outfit, which are consisting of gundas. A picture was shown in Amritsar theater, which is Fire. Name is Fire by Deepa Sahi. Theater was smashed because that political outfit was opposed to that particular movie. As these days we are having that the people who express dissent must be killed. Police, Supreme Police was very much of the view that this man should not be given security, so he got an opportunity that this gentleman is indulgent gundaism. He made a recommendation to the IG security that his jet security be withdrawn. IG security also knew about it. He withdrew the jet security. After 3 days, the Home Minister of India writes a letter to the Chief Minister of Punjab, restore the security. Matter traveled to the court in a PIL. We took cognizance, issued notice, called for the record, called for the information about the security provided to the private citizens by the police. Now that is the question of moral of the police, where the policemen would work, like this Gurmeet Singh. 372 people, private citizens, were given police security at government expense, that is public expense. And you will be surprised to know 33 of them were charged with the crimes of rape, dacoity, kidnapping, etc. And one gentleman who happened to be the chief minister of the state became governor of a state, some other state, in his private village, in his own name, there were 50 security persons posted there. Where will be the moral of the police? How the policemen would feel about it? And when I was just stunned, not as a judge of the former judge of the Supreme Court or the High Court, but as a common man, I was stunned how this gentleman who was facing a serious charge of rape was visited by politicians and the security persons were giving him cover. The recent report which has been published in some newspaper says, in one country, there are few hundred so-called VVIPs. And in our country, there are number is 5 lakhs plus. What type of security? For example, myself, I had the audacity to write in 2007 or 2008 to the concern, my secretary wrote that security be withdrawn from my place. And prompt came reply, this is not your business. Now this is high time, and I will personally convey to Mr. Prakash Singh my all support for the steps which he has initiated. And I would request, because I do not have sufficient time today, therefore my talk will remain inconclusive. Another conference, please don't bother about the time. People should be made to come with a mindset they will sit in the room for 2 days to deliberate upon the subject. This 3 hours conference where 10 persons are speaking is not enough. Unless we go minutely into the issue and hear the stakeholders, please bring some constables, some sub-inspectors. Let them express their views, what do they feel, how the reforms are possible. Otherwise, as one line sentence by Mr. R.K. Singh said, in what conditions a policeman lives? Think of that. For years together, they are away from their families. And still you expect, he must behave like a gentleman with everybody. Now, a police constable or a sub-inspector can't meet the challenges posed by his superiors, by the political outfits, by the bureaucrats, and therefore whenever he gets opportunity, he lends his frustration on the common men. That all needs to be reformed, but a thorough discussion is required to be made on the subject. Unless the government of the day is prepared to spend money on the common man in the force, not the top, forget about the top, common man in the force, we can't talk of reforms. I know the condition of the people who serve at our places in the judges' quarters, where their children go for education. Where do they live? How do they live? Unless those conditions are changed, we do not have to think about the reforms. Therefore, a greater debate is required on various facets concerning the police organization as a whole. Then only you will be able to, apart from the commissions which they have made their recommendations, and recommendations unfortunately in our country, law commission has given 500 reports, most of them are getting dust somewhere in the secretariat of the government, and so is the fate of all the commissions. Therefore, I would request Prakash Singh ji and his command, full command, to hold another conference, not of 3 hours, but for full day, where each one, because the persons, public wants to ask questions from us. We don't have time to answer. Unless thorough debate is there, these superficial debates will not help. I will speak, one minister will speak, two politicians will speak, one lawyer will speak. That is not a satisfactory way of deliberating upon an important issue like this. But still, I wish all the best to Prakash Singh ji and his team that they have thought of organizing this seminar today for a period of 3 hours. Thank you very much, please.